This Sunday, you get to sing again choir. Yay! Things seem to be getting a little bit better in our neck of the woods. So I think that we will be fine to stay in the loft through the whole service. Also, Anita's service last week kind of helped me solidify that decision. Like, yeah, we'll be fine. We can be in the loft together. Okay, we will still keep our masks on. I want to wait until we are told under no more yet we can take them off for good. So I just want to wait a little bit on that. Linda and Dottie have been hemming some of our choir robes so that they are better for people to wear. That includes you, Miss Thelma. Yes, ma'am. Yes, I think Dottie might be the one that has your robe, and she took it up a good 2 inches at least. So that should help a lot. And Maggie's not here tonight, but I know that she ordered a robe for herself about 4 years ago when she had needed something because hers was dragging. So it just might be time for us to order a few more petite robes, and that'll be on my list of things to do. I know it's important, so I don't want to forget about it. Okay, let's go ahead and because it is a Thursday, before we sing and church, we will go ahead and do our hymns as well, which I do have to tell Jim ahead of time. That's why he's writing them down. Let's go ahead and stand up first, warm up a little bit that way. Let's, I'm going to actually skip Dewey, and we'll do our new one, which is NBC. If you're not sure you know that, it's the jingle. It's the NBC jingle. So you know it. Yep. You got it. Okay, so let's do that together.
NBC.
Another one.
NBC. Number the love of your people.
melody for them.
I know.
A little watermelon. Yeah. And you only get one shot at it too, which is like, oh. Okay, moving on to number 543. This is our sending hymn. Maybe not the exact words, but definitely the all through the night part. Yeah.
This is my
father's world. Yeah. Okay, verses 1 and 2 again, so we can practice the harmony.
Thank you.
draw us in the Spirit's Tether. We don't need to meet any earlier than 9:30, so 9:30 in the choir loft with your robes on would be great. If you are involved with Sunday school and you really don't want to miss the ending, it's okay for you to come in, you know, by 9:45-ish. Just try to get here as soon as you can. But yeah. So yeah, draw Spirit's Tether this Sunday, 9:30 in the choir loft. Okay, so is there anything to say? Not really. Okay, before we do the whole thing, let's just take a moment to go over verse 2, and we will get Jim to help us out with that one. Is this an organ?
It is an organ.
Verse 2 is on page 4. Okay, this is one that will be a cappella, but we'll go ahead and hear it. We'll hear it a little help.
Thank you.
Voice parts come in. So I'm going to start with the bass. taking it at tempo. Let's go just a little slower, okay? So, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Okay.
So you're gonna do your bass. Your turn. With helpers, right? Yep. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. I know who Lawrence Welk is. My grandparents were putting that on when they were babysitting me, you know.
It's still on.
Is it still on? I'd be really surprised. I think it's past its time now. But anyway, so add those little diction rests so we get nice, crisp, clear diction. Okay? And repeat at will is a total of 3 times. We won't go crazy. Okay. So, page 8, you don't have to stand, but go ahead and sit up so that you can breathe, okay? All right. 1, 2, 3, 4.
In your world, order my tongue. In your world, guide my feet.
does it is the last phrase, order my steps in.
Steps in.
Yep. That's at measure 75. We're going to add the ps and to in. Yeah. Order my steps in. When the basses sing, wash my heart, O Lord, in your word. Okay? So you're going to sing heart, O Lord. Mm-hmm. Wash my heart, O Lord, in your word. It's just a way to make sure that comes out on that spot. Right? And I'm expecting that you'll have not only Matt, but hopefully Joe on this one too. Because yeah, the bass part's kind of prominent on this one. It's hard to do it all by yourself.
I don't mind it. I've done it a few years.
You've done a great job with it, but yeah, it's just it would be hard for anybody to do it all by themselves.
Okay. I just enjoy it.
Yes. And then, if you see me doing strange things on page 10, it seems like I'm coming at you and then going away. Coming at you. I'm doing that on purpose because on measure 65 we had written in a crescendo on that dotted half note, and then there's already a decrescendo. But then I added a new crescendo, measure 67, and then we come back down on measure 68. So we are feeling like it's, yeah, like you're on a boat and it's the waves going. Makes it interesting. We got really quiet. I think that's the most quiet it's been in the choir in a very long time. Wow!
I think I've seen the mark.
That was rapt attention. I'm so impressed. Thank you.
The one you were just talking about with the basis on that one.
That's the bottom of page 8.
Okay, because I lost track on that.
Where you have it say, wash my heart, O Lord.
That's it.
Go ahead and make it heart, O Lord.
Heart, O Lord. Okay.
You got it. All right.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
On measure 66.
Coming, 66. Sorry, I wasn't looking at where the pianist looks. Oh, I'm looking at the voices.
Cooling out.
Chill out. That's where you start swaying your head.
Is that like some kind of particular key of what not supposed to be?
That's an excellent question that I cannot answer. I can only make an educated guess. I did. I'll get to see it in a little bit. It is that when you're supposed to stand up and play like this? So friends, let's go ahead and sing the whole thing.
Okay.
Let's sing the whole thing. Stand up, please. I don't think there's anything else that needs to be clarified. I think we've got this. Okay.
Yule, is that what you mean?
Short break where?
Before Yule, you take some short breaks.
Yeah, there's a breath mark. Yeah. Yes. So much more interesting when you guys are really soft in a really soft spot.
Yeah.
And then you get big and then you get soft again. That is so interesting. So do that again. You only have to do it two more times, next Thursday and Sunday the 10th. Boo. Great. I'm a good evening, man. I'm a happy person. Okay.
Lisa, I just want to make a quick apology for everybody who got my hacked email.
That's right. I did see that.
Goodness. I sincerely apologize. It was hacked, so if you got it, just delete it, please.
Yeah, no problem. Did you guys change your password?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah. Well, you know, Pastor that happens to his email a lot too, and it's like, excuse me, and how are you this wonderful afternoon? And well, I have this very important. It's too formal.
Yeah.
So I knew right away when it said Frederick E. Borchers. I'm like, it's all good. Thank you.
I apologize.
It happens to the best of us. Yes. So let's just quickly look at something new. This is new to everybody. It's called Look, You Saints, the Cloud of Witness. Chosen for All Saints Sunday, basically for the words. It fits right in with how we usually commemorate All Saints Sunday. So the music is by Jonathan Crutchfield, who also wrote the Neither Death Nor Life anthem that you like so much. And it's arranged by Joseph Martin, and we know how much we like his arrangements already. So I think we will like this. As you see, it was written for Congregation and Handels, and I did choose it way back, like in June, but that's okay. We're still gonna do it because it can still be done very well with organ without the handbells, so we'll be fine if we don't have that. Mm-hmm. It looks a little more complicated than it really is. It is written for congregation to sing along if they do so choose, so it can't be too difficult, right? So there's a longish introduction, and then at the bottom of page 4 is where we come in. We're singing in unison. All right. I think it is unison the whole verse. Yep. I'm not seeing any division, so there you go. So that's nice. First verse down. Okay, second verse starts at the bottom of page 7. Right now that's written as an a cappella, 4-part. There's always a pattern with our choral anthems, and that's one of them. We will certainly plan to do it in a cappella for now, because we have over a month to start to learn it. I think it'll be fine. Jim is always really good about bailing us out at the last second if necessary. we'll plan for it to be a cappella. We'll plan for it. Thank you. Very, very much appreciated. And then it wouldn't be a newer composer's anthem without a key change. So there's the key change at the bottom of 9. Oh, did it? I missed that. Thank you. Oh, sure did. Yeah. Well, that wasn't our singing. That's why I ignored it. We're on the second key change. Yeah. So it is choir and congregation on that second line, and that is almost unison. It finally splits at bottom of 11. Okay. And there is a descant. It says optional, and I guess it will really depend on how many sopranos we have. If we make that, it might just be like a 1 or 2 person descant if we need to have more people on the SATB part at the bottom of 11.
Maybe Matt can do that on the trumpet.
Well, we could. I was going to have him do trumpet on the Reformation.
Okay.
Yeah.
I mean, just.
I mean, that's a nice idea. But I think I've got at least one soprano that can do that descant, so I think we'll be
I said, wonder who.
I go get you too. And then page 12, it's just the choir finishes us out. And there is a bass split there, Rich, as you see, and we'll worry about that when we have more than two basses.
I'm willing to do whatever.
Yeah, I know. You're good. Okay. So that's mapping it out. Let's go ahead and sight read it, and we will definitely take the help as much as we can. I don't think I'm going to pull apart verse 2 tonight, though. We'll save that for another time. So this is sight reading. This is sight reading that you're expected to make mistakes, so don't beat yourself up over it if you make a mistake. It's okay. That's what October is for, is to get this known better.
Start at page 7 on page 4.
Yes, so we don't have to hear the first key change, huh? Yes, 7 sounds good. Thank you.
Oh, there's 2, there's 3.
Yeah. I know, there's a Ross nose, too. And I'm like, oh, okay.
Can it even
happen? I don't know. Does Oregon have to come in there?
Yeah.
I guess he is in there.
That's 6. Definitely can't sing this in the summer.
Yeah.
And it's like, oh, we can read that. Yay. Very, very helpful. Very, very helpful. Good. I think that's going
to
come along just fine. Very nice.
It's cool. Cool when you can read the notes and not what you're reading otherwise.
Yes.
Yes. I'll just
okay.
I don't have my watch on tonight, you guys. Can you help me know what time it is? 8:34?
Yeah.
Oh, I got plenty of time. Okay. So I'm gonna stay put and enjoy Speak, O Lord, with you guys. We'll get this one ready for the 10th. Yes. Okay. Good. I'm glad I don't have to rush. That makes me feel better. All right, so now we're moving on to Speak, O Lord. We have taken the time to review the first and second verses already. I know some of it got lost on the computer, the recorder. I'm going to check and make sure it's still recording because I'm getting a little tired of not recording. I did everything this time to make it work, so if it's not working, it's something else.
Thank you.
lies on the second verse. Oh yeah, guys have the melody and we have the harmony and we come in a little late. And then you were fine right after that.
Came back on the board.
It was 3-10. So when you have more guys with you can be gentle with that, but you can sing a little louder on that for this evening. So we'll try to be a little softer. Women, if you haven't changed the dynamic marking on top of 6 yet, change it from mezzo forte to mezzo piano. Let's give the men a chance to be heard on the melody there. Okay. Then the sopranos steal away the melody in page 7 anyway, so. I'm going to let you have it for so long that you take it right back. Okay. Good job going right into the key change. It's nice that Lloyd Larson wrote that change so well, so it was easy to find our notes. It was helpful. And that slow down, the retard that Jim took, that was pretty much what we're going to do there. Okay, so it will be broader, be a little slower at page 9, like you did. So. Amen, I think went well too. I didn't hear anything that made me go, oh, we got to do that.
The second amen.
The second amen? Measure 16.